Motion capture, aka mocap, is an industry standard method for capturing different aspects of an actor's performance, like general movements or facial expressions, and then converting them into digital data. This data can be used in many different ways, like applying it to an animated character for more realistic movements or taking it up a notch and creating full-on digital humans in movies. Motion capture can find its roots all the way back to the 1910s, when an animator named Max Fleischer came up with a technique called rotoscoping. He used rotoscoping in his animated series called Out of the Inkwell, and the way it worked was Max's brother, David, would dress up as a clown for the role of Coco the Clown, and then act normally for the role in front of the camera. Later on, Max would use the footage as a reference to draw over frame by frame to create the animation by tracking the human movements and translating it to the animated character. Motion capture today works by the same principle, but with different techniques. The most common way of doing motion capture today is to cover the actor's body, mostly around the joints, with reflective markers. The actor will then play his or her role normally in front of many cameras that are designed to track the reflective trackers and save their movement data in a 3D environment. These trackers come in many different varieties with different applications, but they all have the same purpose: tracking body movements or facial expressions in detail that VFX artists can use later for the film project. The use of motion capture in films is ever growing, especially in VFX-heavy movies from The Planet of the Apes and The Lord of the Rings to Marvel Universe and Star Wars films. The most common use of motion capture in films is to animate fantastical characters. Examples of using motion capture for character creation are rampant, but the biggest name in this is Andy Serkis. He's one of the legends when it comes to motion capture. He has a list of characters that he has brought to life, like Caesar from the Planet of the Apes series, Gollum from the Lord of the Rings, Supreme Leader Snoke from the recent Star Wars series, and Captain Haddock from the Adventures of Tintin. Serkis even played two roles in the 2005 Peter Jackson's adaptation of King Kong, one as the Kong himself in a motion capture style, and one as Lumpy the Cook in a normal acting style. In all of these roles, you can see that by using these special suits and cameras specifically made for motion capture, every movement of the actor is translated to the body movement of the CG character. The other way of using motion capture in the film is specifically designed for capturing the facial expressions, which is called performance capture. In performance capture, the actor's face is covered with trackers and then a camera is mounted on their head facing their face. This way, every movement of facial muscles is tracked and recorded. One of the most notable performances for this method of motion capture is done by Benedict Cumberbatch for the role of Smaug in the Hobbit series. This example shows that motion capture has come to the level that movements and expressions can be translated not only to human-like figures, but onto anything, even a dragon. Another use case of motion capture and performance capture that has become more abundant in the past decade is the process of designing and creating digital humans. Star Wars franchise is one of the pioneers of using this technology in their films. In Rogue One, A Star Wars Story, the VFX team, Industrial Light and Magic, used their award-winning technology to recreate Grand Moff Tarkin, which was played by the late Peter Cushing in 1977. For recreating Grand Moff Tarkin, another actor, Guy Henry, was tasked to play in place of Peter Cushing. The technology requires different scans that need to be done before even the actor sets foot on the filming stage. First, there would be a light scan of the face, which would capture extremely high detailed scans of the face of the actor, capturing every light reaction in different facial expressions. Then there will be another scan done in a Medusa rig owned by Disney Research. After all is done, the performance capture part begins where the actor, in this case Guy Henry, will mount the rig on his head and start performing his parts. Then all this data combined with the scans and digital recreations of Peter Cushing's face, the Grand Moff Tarkin of the film Rogue One, A Star Wars Story, was created. Of course, the process was a bit more detailed and more complicated, so for a deeper explanation of this process, you can check out the great video done by Wired that talks about the history and complete process of creating digital humans. What other characters come to your mind when thinking about the films that used motion capture technology? And which film do you think has nailed it? Let's continue the conversation in the comments below, but before that, do subscribe to our channel if you want to see more videos like this. See you in the comments.